whistle blowing, and a youngin's dream of growing up to ride on a freight train leaving town, not knowing where I'm bound. I don't want to change my mind, but mama tried. One and only rebel child, our family weak and mine. My mama seemed to know what lay in store. Spot a home my Sunday learning, cause the bed I kept on turning, till mama couldn't hold me anymore. But I turned 21 in prison, doing life without parole. No one could steer me wrong, but mama tried.
Mama tried, mama tried to leave me better. But if we are the
guy, that means only leave the game, cause mama tried. Take it on. Dear old daddy asked his soul, left my mom a heavy load. She tried so very hard to fill his shoes, working hours without rest, wanting me to have the best. She tried to raise me right, but I refused. And I turned 21 in prison, doing life without parole. No one could steer me right, but mama tried.
Mama tried, mama tried to raise me better. But please, I deny.
Thousands of happy faces up there looking up here. So let me say to you, good evening, ladies and gentlemen.
Good evening.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen.
Good evening. Now, the nights are very casual. I don't like all this formality, so I took my dicky bow off and opened my shirt. Oh, that's naughty, isn't it? Don't lead me down that path, please. I'm too old for all that now. And I'm wearing my coat. I'm not taking it off today. Oh. Well, I might be persuaded a little later on, but we'll see. Now, the format is going to be, obviously, I'm going to be bringing some songs to you. I sing a lot of country music these days and record in Nashville, and so I just throw a few of those in. But we'll be doing, of course, some of the old 60s that you love so much, including one particular song. What would that be? Yeah. The only problem is I don't know why I can do that because I've forgotten the words. So enjoy yourselves, relax, and we're going to have a little break where we're going to ask you to ask me questions, or just kind of whatever you feel you wish you'd like to ask me. Don't jump off the stage. But apart from that, just be relaxed and enjoy yourself, and we both have a great time. I don't know why I love you, but I do. I don't know why I need you, but I do. I only know I'm lonely, and that I love you only. I don't know why I love you, but I do. I can't sleep nights because I feel so restless. I don't know what to do, I feel so helpless. And since you've been away, I cry both night and day. I don't know why I love you, but I do. My days have been so lonely, my nights have been so blue. I don't know how I manage, but I do. Each night I sit alone and tell myself, but I will fall in love with someone else. Well, I guess I'm wasting time, but I've got to clear my mind. I don't know why I love you, but I do. I don't know why I love you, but I do. His deepest feelings down before her. He showed her all the colors of his heart. He gave her all the dreams his life had woven. And in her hands he watched them fall apart. Wrapped her in his vision of perfection. The burden proved too much for her to take. She couldn't wear the halo that he gave her. She couldn't go on handling each mistake. There are no angels after all. There's only people who only keep and a million ways to fall. She left him with a note of measured sorrow. She thought she would be cruel to be kind. But he had problems trying to forget. Her memory wants the shadows of his mind. Now the spell's finally broken. There are only angels after all. There's only people, only people, and a million ways to fall. A million promises to make, a million liberties to take, a million feelings to face, and a million ways. And a million ways to fall. There's only people, and a million ways to fall. Enough, I did order a rocking chair. I had a rocking chair all the way for the night, but they haven't delivered it. So I don't know, Skinny's standing up here is getting a little tired. Somebody come up here so I can sit on your lap. Tell me, hands of all the people that remember and were around in the 60s. Maybe just, oh, man. Oh, thank you, Mr. Paul. What's your name again? Ace. You fell for it again. Lovely man. Lovely man, ladies and gentlemen. He really is. You see him on the television quite often, yeah?
Yeah.
I hate him. No, he's a really great, he's turned out to be a real friend, a wonderful man. Can't do enough for you. Now, hands up all the people that remember and were around of our age in the 60s. Come on, let me have a look. Yes, well, all I can say is there's a few honest people out there and an awful lot of bloody cowards. Hands up all the 60s people. Come on. Yay. Now tell me, who are your favorite artists doing the 60s? Come on.
Elvis.
Elvis. Oh, my God. Wilson's mom, baby, let me. What's, I beg your pardon? Now, you know, next time I come up here, I'll have to put on board in the act. I'll have to do one Elvis song with me. Can't do him tonight, unfortunately, but I'd love to do him. I think we were all influenced in some way during the 60s by, of course, the King. And I'm not ashamed of that. I mean, I strive always to be my own man and do my own thing. But I have to say that if a man is more admired than Elvis, I haven't met him. So, three cheers for Elvis. Wonderful. I got to tell you, the last time I came out the room at the back, Wales were in the lead by 3. Come on, boys. That's too, too far for me to reach. There you go. Now guess what's coming next? Because I don't know.
Warren and Tommy were lovers.
wanted to give her everything, flowers, presents, and most of all, the wedding ring. He saw a sign for a stock of orange, flowers moved on to problems of red. He grinned in love, found the home, said to her mother, as long as he stayed, tell her I love her, tell her I need her, tell her I may be late, I've something to do, I cannot wait. He drove his car to the racing ground. He was the youngest driver there. The crowd rose as they started to race. From the track they drove at a deadly pace. No one knows what happened that day, how this car overturned the flames. But as he drove him from the twisted race, with his dying breath, they heard him say, tell her I love her, tell her I need her, tell her that you cry, my love for her, you'll never die. Night in the chapel, a lot of praise. For her Tommy passed away. It was just a love, he lived and died. Alone in the chapel, she in her mind. Tell her I love her. Tell her I need her. Tell her I want you to cry. My love for her.
Thank you so very, very much. Thank you. Thank you very much indeed. I recorded that, of course, in 1960 when I was a young boy in short pants. Well, almost. I mean, give or take a little bit here and there. It's a song that I'm very proud of recording, and it's been with me all these years. And at one stage, there was an awful lot element there. I never knew anything about my discography. So they were saying, oh, yes, yes, Ricky Valens, what else has he done? He's a one-hit wonder, you know. Yeah. No. You look a little closer these days, you'll find out that discographies are now more important and also very flexible from the point of view that whereas years ago we didn't know if we had hits abroad. I found out, for instance, I've had 5 number ones in one country over there. The follow-up to Tell Laura was Moving Away. That was number one in Australia, and in Austria and Scandinavia. So there's a lot of information that we never found out at that particular time. So I just thought I'd tell you that. I'm like, so, is that okay? It's like being in a church, yeah? You didn't tell me it was going to be like this, golly. I had to wear my starched collar, my cassock, and surplus. But it is wonderful to be up here. We've had a great time so far. I mean, the trip has been absolutely wonderful. I love all the driving. We had a great time on the motorways. I missed the turning. We took 2.5 hours to find the bugger again. Boy, was the stress there. It certainly was. Do you know, as you get older, you get more stressful. Isn't that true in today's world? Really, we should just carry on with life. And of course, it's very hard to do that because so many people out there are living under pressure. Now, I was going to tell you a quick story that happened to a gentleman who had not been to church for 20 years. He was in the country, wandering along on a beautiful sunny day. I want you to imagine how it was lovely and warm and lovely breeze, and it was really terrific. And he just looked and he thought, well, you know something, I haven't been to church for 20 years, I think I'll go in. So he goes in and he sits down at the back of the pew and he listens to an incredible, I mean, a really incredible sermon. And he's so impressed that he does something, which we'll tell you in a minute what he does. But he's so impressed, he runs down, all the way down, practically runs, grabs the vicar's hand and nearly shakes it off and says, "Vicar, that was one hell of a sermon." The vicar said, "Well, oh," he said, "that's very nice of you, sir." He said, "to say that is terrific, but please don't use blasphemous words in the house of the Lord." Oh, he said, "Well, I'm sorry, Vicar, I didn't mean it, but I'm so impressed, I just put $1,000 in the box." Vicar said, "No shit."
This morning realized what I had done. I stood alone in the cold gray dawn. I knew I lost my morning sun. I lost my head and I said some things. Now comes the heartache that the morning brings. I know I'm wrong, I couldn't see. I let my world slip away from me. So hey, if you happen to see the most beautiful girl in the world, and if you did, won't she crying? Hey, if you happen to see the most beautiful girl, but walk down. Tell her I'm sorry. Tell her I need my baby. Oh, won't you tell her that I love her? If you happen to see the most beautiful girl, then walk out on me. Tell her I'm sorry. Tell her I need. That I love her.
Thank you very much indeed. Thank you so much. I gotta walk all the way across here now to get a glass of water. Isn't that terrible? All this way to get a glass of water. Bloody Paul Hayes has done it to me again. He's done it, he's always dropping me in it. He really is. This is to you, Paul. You know, one of the things that struck me when I came up here very much was the fact that here we are tonight in this little venue. I never knew that this existed. We've actually been out of the country now for about 13 years. But I have to say, for people like Golly and Paul and anybody else who's in the business and are presenting this kind of music on stage, God bless them all, because there's no music like 60s music, is there? I've been all over the world, and I got to tell you that in 19... what was that date again, Paul? You said 1999 last time.
2009.
It wasn't, no, actually it wasn't. It was in 2001 when I actually recorded my first album in Nashville. And we got into the charts with a song over there, which was really, you know, a tremendous thrill for me. And prior to that, I'd actually gone over to sell a song called Daddy's Little Girl. And we were quite excited because we thought, well, it's a lovely country song, and they're going to eat it up over there. And over here, we couldn't get a first base. So we sent it over, and they invited me to come over. And off I went, and got there to the studio, and it was an enormous place, absolutely. As most places are in settings and things are in America, everything's huge. It held approximately 1,000 people in the studio just alone. And as I was talking to the producer of the show, what should I hear in the background but the strains of Tell All I Love? And I went, oh my God, no. So I said to the producer, I said, Bill, can I hear the strains of Big? Oh yeah, Rick, yeah, yeah. He said, we want you to do that in the show. I said, well, I've got the two songs on the show, and you know what, not Tell Laura. Yeah, yeah, man, but you know, you had the biggest number one. He said, you know, we want you to, you've got to do this for us, you know. Of course, I had to do it. And my next question was, well, you know, I don't know much about the station. This is my first time out. I said, how many people are we talking about looking in? He said, well, you know, Rick, he said, we have quite a big following out here. He said, we're the top three American shows. He said, and to be honest about it, he said, some old guys can't even get on this. And that threw the hell out of me then. And he said, we had a census about 2 weeks ago, and we have 70 million people looking at it. And that was the biggest audience I ever played in my life. Thank you very much. Thank you. Bless you. It was a great, great thrill for me, and it's a part of my career that I will always be eternally grateful for, because I really did enjoy it. And we've seen a lot of the world. And of course, whether you read anything about me or not, but 7 months ago, waiting to come over to start my work, and I was taken seriously with a heart attack. And they thought that I would kick the bucket, and that was it. But for some reason along the line, the old man upstairs who looks after everybody said, no, he's not ready to go. And so I'm happy to tell you, here I am tonight, recuperating like hell. Thank you so much. Put your sweet lips a little closer to the phone. Let's pretend we're together all alone. I'll tell the man, turn the jukebox way down low. You can tell your friend there with you. You have to go. Whisper to me. Tell me, do you love me true? Or is he holding you the way I do? Oh, love is blind. Make up your mind. I've got to know. Should I hang up, or will you tell him you have to go? You can't say the words I want to hear when you're with another man. Tell me, do you love me, yes or no? Darling, I will understand. Put your sweet lips